wonderful meter. Lano and Woodley!
Clapping yourself. Is that all right?
That's all right. I haven't even clapped yourself.
Welcome back to the show. So great to have you on all the time, including now. So thank you.
Thank you.
So you're tackling one of the greatest stories ever told. This is quite ambitious. Which one is Moby and which one is Dick?
Well, based on the fact that I thought we were wearing costume, I think it's pretty clear that I'm the dick in this particular incident.
Yes, or the dickhead.
Didn't you say we're wearing costume for this? Okay, anyway, but you're...
No, I said yeah, nah, yeah. When you asked me whether we were wearing costumes.
Oh, you said yeah, nah, yeah?
Yeah, nah, yeah.
Well, that means yeah.
No, but
you... Doesn't it? If you say, are we wearing costume, and someone says yeah, nah, yeah, that means yeah, doesn't it?
Yeah, nah,
means no.
But yeah, nah, yeah means yeah. And yeah, nah means
he's playing the dick, and I'm playing the music dance producer, Moby.
I had seen the show, so I'm not going to give too much away, apart from the fact that I loved it. But those that maybe aren't fully across the Moby Dick story, can you give us a...
It's the classic tale, Captain Ahab. He gets his leg bitten off by a whale.
Captain Ahab?
Captain Ahab, yes.
Have you been calling him Captain Ahab through the whole season?
Because that's his name.
I thought it was Captain Rehab.
No, Captain Ahab.
Oh, really? Oh, OK. No worries.
Captain Ahab gets...
So why do you sing that song, What Shall We Do With a Drunken Sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? We had an intervention, tried to put him into rehab, but he said no, no, no. You sing that. He sings, I don't know why you would sing that.
Anyway,
Hang on, my thing's on the wrong side.
What is?
My thing's on the wrong side. No, we're good to go.
Captain Ahab, he gets his leg bitten off by a whale for scientific purposes, and then he seeks revenge, of course, and tries to and his demented quest for revenge and tries to kill the white whale, Moby Dick.
Yeah.
Yes.
See, I mean, it's such a great story. My concern would be we've seen you guys on stage, and sometimes you get distracted.
Oh,
so if I'm coming to see Moby Dick, am I going to see the whole story? Are you guys going to get? Yeah.
Well, it's a bit like Fly, the story about the Wright brothers that we did about 28 years ago. I'm not sure when it was, but...
The award-winning show, Fly.
You know, the 20 minutes of the show is me telling the story of Moby Dick and 50 minutes is of him just trying to sabotage everything, basically. So, I mean, he didn't even come to a single day of rehearsal.
Oh,
I think on the first day he rang up and said he couldn't come because he had to go to hospital because he'd breathed in far too much Milo.
I'm an enthusiast.
I haven't understood one thing you've said so far, but anyway.
I haven't either, Steve.
You haven't understood because you haven't been listening, quite frankly, Mr. Price.
Correct.
I think you've been checking your phone most of the time.
Yeah, no, yeah. Now, you've got all the stories in the world to choose from.
Yes.
Frank.
Yes.
I'll ignore him. Why Moby Dick?
Well, because Colin had actually, during lockdown, he had read the book. He thought that would be a good way to fill in the time during lockdown to read Moby Dick. And so when we were deciding what show we do, he said, why don't we do Moby Dick? So I'm just glad he hadn't been reading 50 Shades of Grey. Or it would be a very different show we'd be performing now. There'd be strap on your peg leg, but a whole different... There she blows.
You guys weren't touring for ages. I don't know whether there was a bust up or something. But now you're back together and everything's good.
Yes, we're back together, and it's a joy. It absolutely is a joy. There's no jokes at the end of what I'm going to say now, but it's absolute joy to be on stage with Frank once again, and the people are having a lovely time. We've got a set. It's a theatrical extravaganza. We've got a huge sale that we have huge projections on.
It's so funny.
Yes.
At one point, we project a big blue wave, although for the sake of topicality, we might call it a big teal wave we project across the back, and, you know, it's...
Very nice.
Yeah, topical, but not that funny.
You can't have everything.
Can I tell you, on a personal note, I know you both separately, but I've never seen you perform together.
Yes, yes.
And it was such a joy to see the amazing chemistry. You're like brothers, or it's an amazing duo.
It's funny you should say
we're like... After decades of knowing each other so well, it was just beautiful.
It's funny you should say that we're like brothers, because Colin often... No, seriously, Colin, Jackson. Aside, mate.
Yes, you're like brothers.
We are, because Colin often pins me down and dribbles in my mouth.
Brotherly love.
Yeah. It's a beautiful thing.
Hey, I think that joke's 38 years old.
Today! Happy birthday.
But in the teal way. Yeah.
A lot of TV shows seem to be coming back, which is great. But it makes me wonder, The Adventures of Lano and Woodley.
I think it's ready for a reboot.
Well, we've got a special announcement tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
We can't have two
exclusives. Waleed is going to produce our new series of The Adventures of Lano and Woodley, and thank you so much for contributing.
I'm more than happy to ruin your career.
Well, thanks very much. Thanks for having us.
No, not at all.
See Moby Dick, everyone.
Details are where you can are available on our website, Lano and Woodley. Thanks very much for joining us.